Hallelujah. Let's clap better to Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. We just want to trust that everyone understands the English language so that it will speed up our work. Hallelujah. Can we just sit up, stand up? Just a minute, stand up. To go, Jesus, I surrender. we acknowledge the presence of God and of the Holy Spirit. And we know that God is with us. If we can see God on His name, God will be with us. We thank everybody for traveling wherever you come from to be here. We are not coincidental present, but that God ordained, and we love that we fellowship together today. So, if you are really present, cheer up your spirit and let us worship God. We acknowledge our father and mother here, Reverend Nanda and then Evangelist Mary. Once again for their presence. God bless them for partnering with us. For partnering with us. They may be the oldest among us. They may be the oldest among us. And we thank God for giving them that understanding of the we are carrying on. What we don't understand, you cannot embrace. What we don't understand, you cannot receive. So, for they receiving us, partnering and fellowshipping with us, we believe that it is an understanding of the Lord that He has given unto them. Remember, we are in the last days, and the last days are days of faith. Bible says that many are going to faint in the last days. Even young men are going to faint. Strength, people with strength, they are going to faint. But the last days are fainting days. That is why we will sing that, let us sing that song, Lord, we surrender to you. We are at the edge of time that if you can't daily surrender to God, you cannot be. These are days of falling and fainting. What Jesus will not sin, will not happen. But if Jesus said, then it has to happen. Jesus summarized the work in the church and said that definitely many are pursuing, but they will not last. Many are sent for that church, but they will not end. Many are carried along, but they will cease on the way. A young man asked Jesus, how many people will enter the kingdom of God? Is it only a few people? And Jesus said, that should not bother you much, but that strive. In other words, work hard. Enter by the narrow gate. For many will try, but they will fail. So, to some people, they are just trying. But to succeed, to take the grace of God. That is why we daily need the grace of God. So if we see people like this, and they have battled with the Lord until now, then they deserve honor. If every one of us will grow old with Christ, then there is hope for what we are doing. If somebody will not give up, then there is hope. I do see some people who God converted 4 years ago. I said, you just have 4 years and you are dying. Count the number of years ahead. You see, some of us, we have just known Christ for some 2 years now. That is how some people have known Jesus. The day we started living by the Holy Ghost, it has not reached any year. And you are getting tired. Then you can't play the years ahead. What I'm saying is that there is more reason not to give up. There is more reason not to give up. There is more reason not to give up. And if we sing this way, we should not look at the journey at our feet. But we know that the journey is always ahead of us. Jesus was always headed towards the vision. Said that he traveled until he reached where he must be crucified. Then he was headed towards Jerusalem until they crucified him and blocked the will of God back. Peter was speaking about this when they raised their prayer in Acts chapter 4. He said that Father, this they did to your anointed one, but it is you who foreordained it that it should go down. So by the will of God, Christ traveled until he met the will of God. Now I want you to know that our decision to serve Christ must be solidified on a hard foundation. Our decision to be Christian should be mature, because many are going to fear their master. Many are going to faint on the way. He said, I will not delight in anyone who tempts me. I will not delight. So if you read that scripture, you will see what Paul spoke. If we believe he is the author of the book. Hebrews chapter 10, verse 36. Can somebody read it for me? Hebrews 10, 36.
Hebrews chapter 10 verse 36. Patient endurance is what you need now, so that you will continue to do God's will.
Okay, read from 35, please.
So do not throw away this confident trust in the Lord.
So do not throw away this confident trust in the Lord.
Remember the great reward it brings you.
Remember the great reward it brings you.
Patient endurance is what you need now.
Patient endurance is what you need now.
So that you will continue to do God's will.
So that you will continue to do God's will.
Then you will receive all that he has promised.
That you will receive all that he has promised.
In just a little while, the coming one will come and not delay.
Well, in just a little while, the coming one will come and not delay.
And my righteous ones will live by faith.
And my righteous ones will live by faith.
But I will take no pleasure in anyone who turns away.
I will take no pleasure in anyone who turns away.
But we are not those who turn away from God to their own destruction.
But we are not those who turn away from God to their own destruction.
We are the faithful ones whose souls will be saved.
We are the faithful ones whose souls will be saved. And did not cast away this confidence that we trust in the Lord.